I've always liked railways, ever since my first Hornby Timplate train set. I was born within Scythe and Marshalling Yard at Wath-on-Dearne. Beyond, I could see the Midland Main Line. I went train spotting at the Cutting, where I watched peaks hauling the Thames Clyde Express from London to Glasgow. In my teenage years, I discovered Buxton in Derbyshire. For many years, I planned to make a model of Buxton Station, but it never quite happened. However, I am making a model of Little Salkeld on the Settle Carlisle Railway, but that's another story. Almost everything I have mentioned is now gone. Tinplate train sets are no more. Wath Yard is now hidden under tin sheds, as are all the coal mines. The Midland Main Line, the Cutting where I went train spotting, is no more. The Thames Clyde Express is a distant memory. The station at Buxton has made way for a supermarket. Railways have made a huge impact on our lives. To state the obvious, they allowed us to travel. They fed the cities. Where does milk come from? No, not a cow, but from a train travelling from Appleby to London. Fish and chips? Impossible without fish vans from Grimsby. Railways led to commuting and suburbs. They mobilised troops and won two world wars. Railways have also made an impact on the landscape. John Ruskin, a great 19th century thinker, wrote, "There was a rocky valley between Bakewell and Buxton. You might have seen the gods there morning and evening. You cared neither for gods or grass, but cash. You thought you could get it by what the Times called railroad enterprise. You enterprised a railroad through the valley. You blasted its rocks away, heaped thousands of tons of shale into its lovely stream. The valley is gone, and the gods with it. And now every fool in Buxton can be at Bakewell in half an hour." A century later, the railway is gone. What remains is a majestic viaduct in Monsaldale and a wonderful walk along the Monsal Trail. The gods once more roam in the valley. We're here at Tebay Services. Long before the M6 was built, the Lancaster and Carlisle Railway built a line through the Lune Gorge on its way to Carlisle and beyond to Scotland. Tebay was a tiny village, but it became famous because of the railway. Tebay sits at the bottom of one of the great railway hills, the Climb Up Shap. It is 1 in 75. You hardly notice it today, but steam engines struggled, so they received some help from a banker. An engine joined the back of the train at Tebay and helped push it up the bank to Shap. So Tebay became famous beyond its station, which closed, by the way, in 1968. Today we're sitting in a motorway service station at Tebay, except we seem to have dropped the station bit. We can see over the fell to the West Coast Main Line. The Virgin Pendolinos hardly notice the long climb up Shap. Passengers, or customers as we have now become, hardly notice the scenery they are passing through. I wonder if they have any thoughts for the men who built the line, which opened exactly 170 years ago this year. Railways have changed our lives. They have changed the landscape. They are controversial. Ruskin hated the line through Monsaldale, but that was nothing compared with the impact that HS2 will have. Railways pass through the countryside. We pass through life. Railways change lives. And we have the opportunity to do the same. What a thought that is.